Hi guys, this is Karan this side. Welcome to another episode of Kicking It with Karan. And today we've got Jason with us. We're going to talk about Microsoft.
To be able to build an autonomous cloud, you have to have a truly integrated cloud. It was exactly this problem that led us to the instrumental partnership that we announced with Microsoft in June.
It is super exciting to be here. Microsoft, Oracle, we're really connected in making sure that we're hearing what the customers need, understanding your cloud journey, and our intent is to empower organizations to deploy the right strategy for your business.
Welcome, Jason.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for letting me interview you. Well, it's not really an interview, but we're just going to have a chat. I'm wearing Microsoft.
Yeah, I was going to say,
so I'm repping the enemy. But they're not enemy in this case, right? They're our friends. So why don't you introduce yourself, tell us a little bit about what Microsoft's doing with us.
Yeah, so Jason Wilber, I'm a director of product management at OCI here. And I was part of the initial partnership discussions with Microsoft. So we can talk a little bit about the details of kind of how we got where we're at, something that's been very exciting for our customers. We've got this huge overwhelming response since we launched in June. And collectively, we have a lot of shared customers, and those shared customers are coming to us with a lot of the similar requests. And so this was, a partnership to really embrace that mutual customer.
It just made sense, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So as you really think about it, Microsoft and Oracle, they're almost the same age. Both of them are over 40-year-old companies. We have a deep history of customers that have these on-prem investments, across their stack. And as we're having conversations with, our enterprise customers, a common concern they have is, how do I make this migration to the cloud as easy as possible? And how do I mitigate risk? How do I lower cost? And, do all of this in a really easy way. And part of that is bringing their existing investments along with them out of the on-prem data
centers. From a technology perspective, right? So this is basically multi-cloud, right? And we know most enterprises are going to be multi-cloud eventually. So we've already sort of like hooked onto that idea, and that's what we're really doing here, right?
Yeah. So if you think about the way I think about it is this is the first true multi-cloud offering. So if you think about multi-cloud, most enterprises are looking at doing various investments in different clouds, but that does induce some operational complexity and other things. So what we really looked at was ourselves and Microsoft can come together and we can create this network connection. We can create kind of the similar ops model. We can layer on collective and joint support. Mm-hmm. And we can do things that ultimately a customer would have had to do on their own in a multi-cloud offering.
Right.
But we're doing it together with Microsoft to make that much easier for customers.
So help me understand, right? Like today you can do multi-cloud in general. So, if I'm a developer willy-nilly and my boss came and said, hey, why don't you deploy something on Microsoft and deploy something on AWS, as an example. I could go do that. I could write some code that talks to AWS and talks to... So what's so different about like Oracle and Microsoft in the sense like Azure and OCI? What makes it technically differentiated that I should choose the pair, which is this, versus something else?
Yeah, so certainly. So there's a couple different things that the partnership includes. One of them is the technical integration. Another is the support criteria that we've come together and done this joint support.
Yeah.
And then a lot of it is that joint training and technical documentation that we've associated with that. So I think there's a couple different components of that.
Yeah.
On the technical side, what we've done is we've enabled a direct connection between our data centers where we're closest. So today we're launched in Ashburn on the East Coast, US East, and then out in London. And that's a direct connection, a private connection between our two data centers. Very low latency, very secure, very high bandwidth.
So almost looks like one cloud.
Almost looks like one cloud.
Right.
And then you can basically take that and you can layer on an operational model now because we have seamless identity. So you can log in once, and then you can move between the portal and the consoles from our respective offerings.
Wow.
And as a developer, you now have that seamless experience. If you extend that now into like applications running on-prem or even in the cloud, like you can extend that identity model across all of the various kind of scenarios that you're running through your data centers and cloud environments.
Very cool. Okay, so we have a really sort of singular, centralized experience to use two different cloud providers. So you've made it easy. What are some of the use cases that we can do with this? Like, I mean, I understand sort of the typical run databases here, run SQL Server there, but like beyond that, like what are some cool things that people should be thinking about?
Yeah, so we're seeing, so we certainly see that use case where you know, a lot of Oracle database customers, you know, we have deep investments, customers have deep investments with Exadata, Rack, you know, other things that they really love, and they want to bring those into the cloud, and this is, you know, certainly something there. We're also starting to see these kind of emerging use cases, the way I think about it. If you think about what we built, it's kind of a platform, and with us and Microsoft coming together, it's unlocking all these new use cases. One of them is a use case where customers can leverage IoT offerings on the Microsoft side. They can actually build in models and other data collection through the edge and actually bring that over to OCI and merge that with the data sets that they might have within Oracle Database, be able to change the models around how they're leveraging that data, and then ultimately deploy that on a front end in Microsoft.
Right. So it's really providing more value essentially to multi-cloud, right? That wasn't possible before. Cool, all right, so to end, is there more coming? Like, am I going to be able to do cool things like singular APIs, or like maybe within the OCI portal, I'll see an Azure dropdown, or in the Azure portal, I'll see an OCI dropdown, or like, do you want to do some breaking news here, or like, no?
So I think the big thing is that we're continuing to evolve this. And so the biggest thing that's coming right now is that we have new regions that are continuing to expand globally.
Great.
So we'll be launching soon in Europe, in Asia. We'll be launching in US West, so we'll have a full US DR site and East Coast data center.
Fantastic.
And then we're going to be going out into a Gov region. And so as you think about that, that's really our priority right now in some respects, is to really expand this to all of our global customers and then continue to build on those capabilities that we've kind of talked about.
Awesome. Well, perfect. Well, thanks for joining me today and giving a quick squeezy look at Microsoft Azure and OCI and what we're doing together. Join us next time for another episode.